We can't just keep ignoring this any longer. I think it's time we talk about gun control.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is Jonathan Paula. Today I'd like to talk about gun control and a few other issues that popped up again this weekend following the incredibly tragic events at Sandy Hook Elementary in Newtown, Connecticut last Friday morning. Now obviously that was a heart-wrenching, incredibly sad event. 26 innocent people lost their lives, 20 of them first grade school children. But this one hit home way harder than most. These are kids with their entire lives ahead of them, completely innocent. They didn't do anything or mean harm to any person. And yet, they are no longer with us. It is a terrible tragedy, but unfortunately, it re-sparks this discussion on gun control, and we can't keep ignoring it. Of America's 10 deadliest mass shootings, 6 of them have happened in just the last 5 years. From Virginia Tech to Aurora, Colorado, to Tucson, Arizona, and now Newtown, Connecticut. We are not just imagining this. It is getting worse. But now that it's been a few days since Sandy Hook, I think it's time we have a reasonable and rational, level-headed conversation about gun control in this country. Now please understand, I am not proposing a full ban on guns. Very few people are. But why does any regular American citizen, hunters and policemen notwithstanding, need access to automatic assault rifles or high-capacity ammunition? Quite frankly, they don't. And if their only justification is the Second Amendment, they need to find a new argument, because that 236-year-old document was written at a time when weapons took over a minute to reload. It is out of date. We need better, more reformed gun control. And over 95% of Americans agree with me. We need better background checks. The fact that mental health checks are not performed in over half of this country is a scary thought. Add in the loopholes associated with gun and trade shows, and you can get guns fairly easily if you want to. And presently there are some strict gun control regulations in certain states and cities. But when the state next to you doesn't have that, it doesn't do a lot of good. We need stuff at the federal level. As the Harvard Injury Control Research Center has proven, more guns in certain areas tend to lead to more homicide. In areas with stricter gun control, they have lower homicide rates. America has the highest murder rate of any first world country on the planet. When you look at per capita, per 100,000 people, America has twice the number of homicides. Now, I excluded third world countries from that list because there are plenty of studies and research to show that violence and murder is closely tied to socioeconomic circumstances. So it's not quite a fair comparison when you put the Congo and America in the same column. Quite frankly, they have a reason for their violence. We don't. When you compare America on a fair playing field, we are number one. I don't want to be number one. These are things that we have to fix. The popular counter-argument to gun control is that criminals don't follow laws anyway, so why bother having more of them? But if we follow this bullshit argument to its logical conclusion, we're effectively saying that if criminals don't follow the laws, why bother having any at all? Seatbelts have known to save lives, but every now and then, someone gets in a car accident while wearing their seatbelt and still dies. Does that mean we should get rid of all seatbelts? Of course not. This is a ridiculous argument. This narrow-minded and defeatist attitude is as selfish as it is ignorant. It's not a good excuse for not trying. Paraphrasing from what President Obama said in a speech a couple nights ago in Newtown, we're not going to be able to stop all the evil in the world, but that doesn't mean we shouldn't try. But one thing we actually shouldn't try is this completely delusional suggestion of bringing more guns into the classroom. Plenty pro-gun owners suggested this week online that if the teachers had guns of their own, maybe they would have stopped this guy in his tracks before he killed so many kids. This is a completely boneheaded suggestion, and it honestly disturbs me that people would suggest bringing weapons into classrooms is a solution to any problem. What if the kid gets a hold of the weapon when the teacher's back is turned? What if it results in a shootout and there's ricochets and even more people are killed? How do we know the teachers are going to be proficient with their weapons and only hit what they're supposed to? Do we train them? Who pays for this training? Are we honestly suggesting that teachers should undergo weapons proficiency training before we teach them how to teach history? This idea is frankly foolish and absurd. More guns are definitely not the answer. Another ridiculous counter-argument I keep hearing is this slippery slope argument that if we ban guns, which again, no one is suggesting, why don't we ban knives, cars, chainsaws, and bats? After all, people have all killed with those objects, right? Well, yes, technically they have, but no one's ever committed a massacre with them. And that's where the transitive property fails. A bat is not the same as a gun. A bat was designed to play baseball. A gun was designed with the sole intention to kill and maim. They're not the same thing. No one's ever gone on a bat rampage before. So no, we're not going to create a law that says all of these objects are equally dangerous. Because they're not. And to suggest as such is stupid. 4% of Americans suffer from a serious mental illness that is unmedicated or unchecked. And in half the country, those people can buy a firearm without a background check. That is not okay. We need to stop it. Yes, there is a greater problem here dealing with mental health. And we need better mental health facilities in this country. We need to allot more funding to them. We need to stop ignoring the mentally ill and take care of them. But we also can't ignore the gun issue either. There are a lot of things involved here, and we have to do all of them. Or at least, we have to try. Because if all of this can save even one life, it's worth it. We can't sit on our ass and ignore it, or pretend like none of this is going to solve anything. Because that pessimistic attitude is what got us here in the first place. Quickly, I want to discuss a couple other issues that sprung up after the Sandy Hook tragedy. Namely, these swarms of vitriolic people going to Facebook pages of whom they thought to be the killer and leaving all of these hateful comments. These lynch mobs are brainless, impatient forces of idiocy and anger. Avoid the temptation to join them. Please, ignore them altogether. And the same goes for the killer and the Westboro Baptist Church. Don't give them any attention, time, discussion, or thought. They are the absolute scum of the planet. That's all I have to say for this video, but please let me know what you think about this story in the comments down below. But for now, that is the world according to me. My name is John. Thank you for watching and listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.